They told you about the new parts that have come in from the factory, right? Well, they're all fitted and good to go. I hope they do the trick. Don't push the car just yet. Track is still green. Try to take it easy for the first couple of laps. programme complete and a job well done. We've got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. Okay, that's all the checks complete. We're ready to go. Approaching the DRS zone, watch your MFD for the activation point. Great stuff, mate. You've pretty much nailed this circuit. This is a really strong foundation to build from over the course of the weekend. Fantastic. You obviously have a really good understanding of this circuit. Test complete, and that was a really good job indeed. You got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. All set, we're ready to go, so let's get the car out onto the track. Great lap. You nailed exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. Job so far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. Great lap, you nailed exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. Job so far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. programme complete and a job well done. We've got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers.
The session has drawn to a close, so let's review our top three. The captain, Verstappen. it's time to remind ourselves of our top three, who are Sainz. And with the cars now over the line, let's see our top three again. Perez, Norris, and Carlos Sainz.
Okay, I know you're eager to get out there, but I'm going to need you to be patient for a few minutes. We're just trying to zero in on an oil leak. Okay, when you're ready, let's go.
Remaining now.
With qualifying finished, it's time to remind ourselves once again of our top three. The captain, Ricciardo, and Max Verstappen. Goodbye for now then, but really we're just getting started. Welcome along then to Great Britain and the Great Silverstone Circuit for today's Grand Prix. The 3.6-mile long Silverstone Circuit is one of the longest of the season, with 18 corners in the current layout. With average lap speeds reaching around 145 miles per hour, it's also one of the quickest tracks of the year. Watch out for cars taking the right-handers of Abbey and of Copse flat out. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting race. The captain lines up on pole position, with Daniel Ricciardo slotting in alongside. Considering the rest of the grid, we have Verstappen, Leclerc, Sergio Perez, and Russell. Hamilton, Sainz, Fernando Alonso, and Valtteri Bottas. Aitken, Gasly, Kevin Magnussen, and Vettel. Ocon, Stroll, Mick Schumacher, and Guan Yu Zhou. Norris, Albon, Tsunoda, and Nicholas Latifi. Now it's almost time for lights out, so let's go down to the track. It's just about time to go down to the track for the beginning of the race, but before we do, Anthony Davidson, what types of strategy do you think we can expect for today's event?
Well, there's a lot that both the driver and the team have to keep in mind when going into a race. The tyres, fuel, energy recovery systems, the list goes on and on. But I think the key to today's victory will come down to the pit stop strategy. Come in too soon and you might find yourself needing more than one stop. Too late and you're putting yourself at a disadvantage by spending longer on worn tyres.
After the points finished last race, let's aim to keep that momentum going. Charge you hold, the faster that capacity will drop. We'll be right back. overtake and burn off some of this energy. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Okay, information on Verstappen, they're retiring from the race. work. That's a new fastest lap of the race. So your teammate behind is 18.7 seconds. Use your overtake button, or it's time to utilise some of this energy. Come on. At the moment, just focus on the driving. Behind is 11.0 seconds. We're approaching the pit window now, and you're going to be on hard next time. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 22.9 seconds. Copy that. Okay, Jack's coming in. Please stop now. Okay, those tyres are going to fall off the cliff soon. Take extreme care. That was a fantastic stop, faster than we were expecting. Okay, stay clear of the white line on the exit. You'll receive a penalty for dangerous driving if you cross onto the track. Behind is 22.1 seconds. Our gap behind is 6.5 seconds. fastest lap of the race. Keep this up. Well done. A lot of spare energy, okay to use your overtake button. Thank you. pace, we're leading our teammate by 33.5 seconds. And that's just 5 laps of fuel remaining. Right, we've got enough fuel for 3 more laps. Issues with the tyre wear for now. Keep taking care of it. Okay, information on sites. They've got an issue with their car, they're going to be slow. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. Okay, we've only got one lap of fuel remaining. The gap to your teammate behind is 37.1 seconds. Fantastic drive, that's just fantastic. Amazing, you deserved that race win. Well done, mate.
Here we are then, a fantastic British Grand Prix. And what a performance it was from our race winners today. Well, Anthony Davidson, a resounding victory today. But what set them apart from the rest?
Well, they certainly stood out as a driver with tons of confidence on the track. I think their ability to keep their cool, even during some of the more hectic parts of the race, meant they were able to capitalise on the mistakes of other drivers, giving them the opportunity to make their way to the top spot with ease.
The faces on our top three look so incredibly happy as they make their way up to the podium. A much-deserved victory and a brilliant performance from them all. And after this round of the World Championship, here's how things look in the drivers' table. The captain increases their championship lead. Some amazing talent out on the track today. But Anthony, who would you pick as your driver of the day?
I think for driver of the day, I'd probably pick Lando Norris. He lived up to every inch of his reputation today, and I think he'll be going home.
Let's get a few laps under our belt. Okay, this is the last lap of the programme, final lap of the programme. To lift and coast going into the corners. Don't be too aggressive on the power, but remember, you still have to beat the minimum lap time. Job indeed. You got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. great lap. You nailed exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. So far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. You nailed exactly what we asked for. Keep it up. So far, we're getting great data. Stay focused. Job well done. We got some excellent data with that run, so come on back to the garage and I can take you through the numbers. manage the tyres through a lap, so try to keep the wear down through each corner. Be especially careful accelerating on corner exit. Our tyre data's no good unless we're doing a representative pace. If we don't get our time delta back into the green, we'll need to rerun the programme. Just over 10 minutes time. Rain in 10 minutes. This test is all about tyre management. Try to control the slick through each corner and take extra care putting the power down at the apex. Okay, test complete, and that was a really good job indeed. We got a lot of valuable information out of that. Well done. Okay, just want to remind you to keep an eye on your tyre temperatures, which you can do on the temperature panel of the MFD. We monitor carcass temperature and surface temperature, and you'll get the best performance when they're both inside a normal operating window. Surface temps tend to fluctuate faster, so try a few laps with the data open and get a feel for how to control them. That was a 107.9. correct, so that last lap was at 1:09.4.
The session has drawn to a close, so let's review our top three. We're all ready for tomorrow's race, but before we begin, let's have a quick look at those who'll be front. So it's all about speed in today's sprint, not very many. Let's run you through the driver grid order for today's exciting sprint. The captain lines up on pole position, and Lewis Hamilton completes the front row.
Okay, now that we've got some good points on the board, let's continue this form and aim for another charge your hole, the faster that capacity will drop. That was the fastest lap of the race so far. Okay, clear. lets you overtake and burn off some of this energy. Caution, caution! Okay, so the gap to the car behind is 4.5 seconds. information on Perez. They seem to have an issue. That's us with 5 laps of fuel remaining, 5 laps of fuel left. Okay, so we're leading our teammate by 17.8 seconds. Okay, we're monitoring some wear on the internal combustion engine. Be aware that we're going to start to see a loss of power. We've got enough fuel for 3 more laps. Okay, this is your final lap of the race. thank you for all your hard work out there. That was a strong drive and a great finish. Well done.
And now let's take a look at the driver's standings. The captain increases their championship lead. It's time to check out the constructor's standings. The current leaders continue to extend their lead at the top. Meanwhile, good work from Aston Martin this weekend, who pushed themselves further up the order. Well, that wraps up the sprint. All that remains is the main...